Once upon a time, in the forgotten seaside town of Southfold. There was a crumbling old cottage, home to two old fuddy-duddy parents. And their super smart daughter, who had just been accepted into university. The problem? Well, they didn't want her to go. You see, that girl is me. And this, it's a letter saying I'm running away. At least, I was, until this storm started. Now, I guess we're stuck here until the rain clears. So we may as well get to know each other. My name is Paige, 18 years old, astrophysicist in training. Hobbies include journaling, origami, oh, and bending the space-time continuum. But more on that later. Finally, everyone's asleep. Now, where were we? Mom and Dad wanted me to stay in Southfold. To settle down here. But I always dreamt of bigger things, you know? Creating my own path. When I got the university offer, I thought it was finally my big break. But I wasn't allowed to go. They were worried it was too dangerous out there, in the real world. So, that's how I ended up here. A runaway. With a long journey ahead to the big city. I just hope that, when I graduate, they'll be there, you know? But for now, I've just got to focus on getting out of here. Is that Dad snoring in the other room? Well, that's my cue to leave.
Thank you. Thank you.
We found a quiet corner of the cave and settled in for the night. My new friend promised to deliver my letter home, now that he knew the way back. As I lay by the fire, I fell into a deep sleep and dreamt of home. It was a cool winter morning, and the sun was rising over Southfold. Two twins had arrived earlier that night. A perfect girl called Paige, and a stinker called Oscar. They were inseparable. But I'll have to tell you more another time. It's already morning. We packed up our things and put out the last embers of the fire. After saying goodbye, I set off into the swamps alone. Hopefully there's no alligators.
Thank you. Lambada.
The pair led me to a large tree reaching out of the mangroves. As I climbed into the branches, they yelled that I'd forgotten something. I looked down at their grinning faces and was transported back. My brother Oscar and I played every day together. I'd make little paper animals, and he'd paint these amazing pictures. You'd see in his eyes, he'd get lost in his paintings. And then, one day, he just disappeared. It was like he slipped through the cracks of the world, right in front of me. Does that make sense? Anyway, sounds like another storm's rolling in. I read there should be a village north of these trees. If we hurry, we might be able to make it before sunrise.
Thank you.
Inside the nest, we nervously glanced around. Something didn't feel right. As we searched for the way down, a shadow crept over us. Before I knew what hit me, I was tumbling through the branches below. As I fell, the present gave way to the past. I remembered the first disappearance. Oscar had vanished. Everyone was worried sick. We searched the village high and low until finally... Dad found him playing with bullfrogs down by the water. How he got there? Nobody knew. Everyone was just pleased he was safe. For now. Several hours later, I finally came around. The rain had eased, and I could feel the warmth of the sun. A village was just up ahead, a sense of anticipation hanging in the air. Maybe there's a spare bed for the night. As the villagers gathered round the fire to begin the festivities, the elder took me to one side. He leaned in and whispered that while trapped between, he'd seen unimaginable things. That I should be careful to prevent the same thing happening to me. The party carried on around me as I laid down to rest by the fire. Before long, the laughter of the villagers faded away. I awoke in a dream, adrift in what felt like limbo. Is this what the elders spoke of? A familiar presence waited at the edge of the world and beckoned for me to follow. I awoke to the cool touch of raindrops on my face. It was morning, and the whole village was awake. Had they even slept? They offered some frog tea, which I sipped reluctantly. With my mind still swimming from the night before, I bid them farewell. That wasn't quite the relaxing night's sleep I was hoping for.
Little. Tin 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 tin.
Tin 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 tin. And then. And then.
I won't. Hell yeah. Uh-huh. And they're fine.